Hello friends, in today's class we are going to talk about a concept called overlay. Okay, so welcome here, and we are talking about the concept called overlay. Okay, so overlay enables to run a process that is larger than the memory allocated to it. Okay, so this concept is called overlay. That for example, if I have a allocating the memory, suppose 100 kilobyte, in this 100 kilobyte we can run a process of size, let's say 150 kilobyte. Okay, so that concept is called an overlay. Now overlay is implemented by the user. It is implemented in user space, and operating system is may not be involved in this, or you can say operating system is not aware of it. Okay, so the idea here, that what to do, how to use the overlay in this, we can say that operating system, we load the program module that is required at that instance of time. Okay, so at that instance of the time the module is required, that will be loaded. After that, we can take out that module. Okay, after that we can take out this module and we can load the module. After that, the module not required. Module not required can be taken out of the memory. Okay. So this concept is called the overlay. Okay, so main idea is this, that enable a process that is larger than the memory allocated to it. Okay, keep in memory only those instruction and the data that needed at given time. Okay, we keep the only those instruction and the data that is needed at given time. Needed when the process is larger than the amount of the memory allocated to it. Okay, implement by the user, no special support needed from the operating system. Programming design of overlay structure is complex. Okay, so there are 3 points here, there that it keeps only those instruction and data that is needed at given instance of the time. A larger memory of new process is larger than the memory is allocated to it, and no special support from the operating system. This is an example that consider two pass assembler. During pass one, it construct the symbol table, and during pass two, it generate the machine language code. We may be able to partition the assembler in a pass one and pass two code, and the symbol table is and the common support routines used by the both pass one and pass two. Okay, now suppose there is this one, pass one size 70, pass two size 80, symbol table and common routines are size 30 and 30. Now here we can say that we know that we will be only using pass one and pass two one at a time. Okay, and symbol table and common routines will be both will be used. Okay, to load everything at once, we required how much space? 70, 150, and total 200 kilobytes of the space is required. Okay, if 150 is available, we cannot run our process. However, we notice that pass one and pass two do not need to be in the memory at the same time. Okay, now this is the design, or we can design our system in a such a way, or design our program in a such a way that all the modules may not be required simultaneously. Okay, so now we can have we thus define two overlay. Overlay A as the symbol table, common routines and pass one, and overlay B as the symbol table, common routine and pass two. So simple table is there, 20k, common routine is there, and we have an overlay driver. Okay, this is what overlay driver. Now this overlay driver will be enable pass one and it will enable the pass two. Okay, so extra 10 kilobyte is required for loading and taking care of pass one and pass two. Okay, so that is your simple definition or simple concept of your overlay. And in this, we have only 3 points very important in this case is this. This is the key idea behind overlay, that those instruction and data that needed to keep in memory, only those instruction and data needed at given time, needed when the process is larger, amount of the memory allocated to it, implemented by the user, and complex structure. Okay, so that's all for this discussion. Thank you.